Hello beautiful people, this is Chris from Macombo and I'm here with the RX17 Pro by Oppo, freshly launched here in gorgeous, glamorous Milan. I'm going to do a quick hands-on with it just to show off the specs, the hardware, the software, and everything else you need to know. So as you can see, like many premium smartphones such as the OnePlus 6T, the Oppo RX17 Pro sports a gorgeous front-filling display. Very little in the way of bezel action there, especially down below, quite impressive. Of course, up top you get the now popular water drop notch to only slightly intrude on that display. If we spin it around, you'll see you get this lovely gradient style finish, something that you'll of course have encountered on the likes of the P20 Pro. And you see, as you sort of curve it towards the light, it gets this lovely sort of almost S-shaped light, and it just shears between that purple and that blue coloration. It's absolutely stunning stuff. It almost looks and feels like it is made of metal as well. Definitely stands out from the recent smartphone crowd. Apparently it's Gorilla Glass 6 on the front, not sure about in the back, but that should certainly help to keep it all nice and pristine as well. A 6.4 inch Full HD display is absolutely stunning, as you can see there. Nice punchy colours that really stand out. I believe it's an OLED panel. As you can see there, as usual, you can have a play around with all of the colour output and everything. And this has actually got a built-in fingerprint sensor in the display as well. Heading into the settings, got a fingerprint, face and passcode, and you can get that all set up. It's a very similar setup to the likes of the OnePlus 6T, the Huawei Mate 20 Pro. Just get it enrolled and shows up a little indicator on the screen every time you want to actually unlock the handset, and just a firm press and you're basically straight into your desktops. And of course, just as backup as well, you can enroll your facial info and use your gorgeous mug to unlock the device if for whatever reason you can't use the fingerprint sensor. So just get that enrolled nice, quick and easy. So you can see there, you can actually use the screen to light up your face if it's a bit dim, and you can log directly with your face. And now if we turn the phone off, turn it on, immediately recognizes me and boom, straight into the desktops. Great stuff. And if for whatever reason it can't recognize your face, just use that in-screen fingerprint sensor, boom, again, straight into it. As you can tell, the screen is rather bright as well. Let's just scale that back a little bit because don't need it quite that fearsome. So what is actually running the show? Well, it's Qualcomm's Snapdragon 710 chipset. Certainly seems to do the job here, nice and nippy, backed by 6 gigs of RAM, just to help out with the multitask and things like that, running of apps. Doesn't matter if you get quite a lot of stuff on the go, should still run a dream. It's actually Android Oreo running on the Oppo RX17 Pro with a nice bit of ColorOS version 5.2 slapped on top there, just to change up the general look and feel and add some bonus features in. As you can see, one of those bonus features is unfortunately the culling of the apps drawer, so all the apps have to be stuck away on the desktops unless you actually chuck your own launcher on top. Luckily that's generally pretty straightforward. As you can see, you get a whole bunch of bonus stuff, you can change up the themes. The smart convenience section has quite a lot of funky stuff buried away, such as for instance the smart sidebar. You can just pull that out at any time, as you can see just from the edge here. There we go, eventually managed to get to it. As you see, it just gives you fast access to your favorite apps. You can take a shortcut, you can actually change this up as well, add in other bonus stuff, whatever you like, baby. Got the usual gesture controls and everything. If you've seen our review of the Oppo Find X or the Oppo F9, none of this will really come as much of a surprise. And of course, you gamers have got the game space as well, which can accelerate your graphics, basically dedicate resources to a game. So for instance, if you're a bit of a PUBG fan, the network protection will come in particularly handy. Just stops background apps from sapping all your gorgeous connectivity and slowing your game down. What else is really interesting in the Oppo RX17 Pro is the VOOC Plus battery charging. This actually delivers close to 50 watts of power while you're charging the phone, apparently. And you can get up to 40% of battery charge in just 10 minutes at the plug. Pretty impressive stuff. It's actually a dual cell setup as well, which is supposed to aid with that quick charge. So it'll be interesting to see how that holds up under testing conditions, for sure. As for the rest of the specs, where you get 128 gigs of storage on there, I don't believe it's expandable via micro SD. As you see, a good chunk of that is available for your apps and media though, so you shouldn't run out anytime soon. Now the other really interesting thing about the Oppo RX17 Pro is the triple lens camera tech mounted here on the back. It's a bit different from the one found on the likes of the Mate 20 Pro. You get a 12 megapixel primary lens. It's actually got a dual aperture. It's f1.5 to f2.4. It flips between the two automatically, depending on the surrounding environmental conditions. So hopefully it should prove not quite nice for those night shots. They're actually using the hashtag seize the night for the Oppo RX17 Pro. We'll see how much seizing it does in our tests. It comes complete with dual pixel face detection autofocus and a nice bit of optical image stabilization. You also get a 20 megapixel secondary lens f2.6. And that third lens is a TOF 3D stereo camera. This can actually create a 3D model of your subject at a distance of up to 4 to 5 meters. We dive on into the camera app. It'll immediately look very familiar to anyone who's used an Oppo phone before. Because you've got your standard photo mode, you can dive into a portrait mode, uses that dual lens standard setup in order to capture a nice crisp shot of your subject, blur out the background. Of course, you've got your usual studio lighting and everything as well. You've got the night mode, which can basically take several shots and superimpose them on one another to create a brighter, crisper, cleaner image. You've got, God forbid it, the sticker mode as well, which can basically turn you into a friggin' hippo or whatever. Oh great, I fulfilled my lifelong dream of being a pufferfish. Or just, I don't even know what this is. Like, just what the shit. And of course you've got the full Pro controls, should you need them, to tweak the lights, the ISO levels, the white balance. So that right there in a nutshell is the Oppo RX17 Pro. As you can see, quite a nifty little smartphone. €599, it's coming to Europe. Haven't got a specific UK price or release date yet, so stay tuned for a bit more on that. Will it take on the likes of the OnePlus 6T and the Huawei Mate 20 series? Definitely let us know in the comments below. It'd be very interesting to hear your thoughts on this one. Certainly the hardware seems very nice indeed, even if it doesn't rock the Snapdragon 845 chipset. And I'm definitely very interested in testing out that camera tech. As ever, hit that subscribe button, ding that notifications bell, and have yourselves a lovely day, people. Love you lots. Cheers, bye!